All right. So we're in the letter.
Who's in every Castlevania game?
Death, of course. Yeah. I know Death is a boss. Also, the correct answer is Dracula. Except not, because...
He is not. Well, you don't fight him in every game.
I don't think he's the boss of Aria.
No, he's not. He is also not the boss of... Is it Symphony? No, it's not Symphony. What's the PS2 game?
Oh, I can't remember the 3D games. Also, this was a dead end. Unless that's a pushman down there. God. What is the name of the piece of that game?
It's a really good game.
Lament of Innocence. There we go.
Yeah,
holy
Lament.
Balls.
Lament's one of my favorite games, actually.
Lament looks pretty good. Also, of all, like, fucking... Like, it's weird. Lords of Shadow pulls a lot of stuff from the fucking 3D Castlevanias that, like, nobody played.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's Cornell, the werewolf. And the DLC boss is the Immortal from Lament of Innocence.
Mm-hmm.
And the only way you can tell that is that they have the same name. And if you look, well, spoilers, but at the end of the DLC, God, what's his name? Gabriel. Like, cuts the Immortal in half. And if you look at how he looks in Lament of Innocence, he is cut the same exact way.
Yep.
Which I think is a really good touch.
But he's not dead yet.
No, because he's immortal.
Well, I think he kind of sort of dies the second time you fight him.
Anywho, I found the proper path. The warehouse. I was actually only... Wait, you said that there's four bosses?
Four bosses are left.
No. There has to be... Holy crap, we were just talking about tanky enemies. There has to be...
You want me to say it? Because I'm looking right at it.
No. I think I know. If you're saying death is one of them.
Yeah, death's one. You saw two of the other ones already.
Yeah.
Actually, you've met the rest of the bosses already.
Exactly. I just... Okay. Wow! Fucking tank... I hate to keep harping on the same thing, but holy shit.
Yeah,
nothing should take two direct crosses. For a fucking MP up.
A lot of the enemies in this game, just it gets to the point where it's just not worth it to waste resources on them. It's better just to run by if you can. But sometimes you have to use it, because otherwise you just get trapped between four or five enemies, and then you're screwed.
Does Griffman drop a card?
Griffman?
Griffin.
I think Griffin actually does drop a card.
Probably the wind card.
Griffin's drop Griffin.
It sounds silly, but...
Funny, but... Like... Like, it makes sense.
Like, what if they make Griffin's drop not Griffin? Something else drops Griffin.
Well, I mean, the Earth Demon drops the ice card, so...
Look... Earth's weird, okay?
And we gotta do Pushman puzzles now, because we have Pushman. Once again, this is what I want in my Castlevania game, where you have a lot of mobility, is slowing down. Thunder Armor, I know you got a card. Probably the Thunder card.
No.
The only thing of note that I remember is really nice for the Thunder card is it has Electro Whip, which is really good for finding one hidden room.
Mm-hmm.
Which is that one in the super long drop corridor at the beginning of the game. Because you just have to hit this one specific piece of wall, and if you have the Electro Whip, which gimmick is stays out and consistently does damage, you whip as you're falling and just leave your whip out, and then you'll hit the wall on the way down. Ooh, my, oh, mind. I got excited, I thought I got a super potion. Like, oh,
No, those are a little bit further off.
This is the other thing. Take a drink. Thunder Army, you're making me waste my fucking crossings. It's pissing me off. The least you can do is be courteous and drop your card. Whoa! I'm getting attacked by another poltergeist. I'm starting to remember this area and why I hate it.
Oh, and Mr. Tanky?
No. Poison moths. Also puzzles.
Poison brick puzzle.
Oh, right. There's nothing in this area. Okay, so you gotta push this box first. Break this one, push this one over. Break the other block and push that one over. Oh, I just remembered. I fucking have a fast forward button. Well, I mean, like, I barely use it because why would you want to fast forward in a Castlevania game where something can just kill you outright? And then the weird run mechanic in this game where sometimes running just keeps happening. And then other times it doesn't. I think if you jump and turn... No? Yeah, I don't know. Running is weird. Oh, I seem to remember this puzzle. I think you need to push a box. No, because you can't push a box all the way down here. Wait, can you? How about a box? Ow. And just get notched up from this fucking zone. I will only kill enemies that I'm pretty sure drop cards. I should not kill those bone skeletons, but I think they make doing this upcoming puzzle easier. Killing them, that is. Good, gold armor. I already have that. I mean, in retrospect, since I know I'm killing a bunch of Thunder Armors, I could switch to the, what's it? The,
Silk Robe?
No, just my luck gear and luck up card. Stop wasting time here. Is there any enemies over here I need to be worried about? Nope. Alright, we did this all for a heart tub. Good. 10 out of 10. We'll do puzzle again. And by puzzle, I mean just you gotta fucking push a box all the way down. Not even a puzzle. How does that qualify as a puzzle? It doesn't. Alright. But, speaking of puzzles, now we actually have a puzzle here. Alright, so... Alright, I got it. Whoops, don't want a dagger though. Daggers are poop. Yeah, break the stone block, push box 2 down, and then push box 1 over, and then push box 2 over again. I can take a slower paced puzzle area, that's fine. What are you, holy armor? Laser.
Ooh, careful with those.
Yeah, they seem to do a lot of damage, don't they? I might have gotten hit twice.
Ouch.
I hit the first time, I'm like, oh, they probably do damage. And I got hit a second time, I'm like, yeah, they do damage. Did they drop a card?
Probably.
Because I'm, contemplating not giving a fuck. Shit! Ooh! Oh, boy. Where's my save point?
Just keep progressing, you'll find it eventually.
Box. I need box to get up there. What's this room to my bottom left? Just so I don't have to spawn the holy armor again.
Well, remember that if you walk close to a boss room, you'll see the boss.
I know.
Boss door, so.
In the room that I'm in, what's in this room to my bottom right?
Hold up.
Oh, I found a secret room too. Secret room. Could be. Hold up. It's a heart.
Oh. Sorry.
I built this tomb for myself. Might as well take it. I did get a chicken. I'm gonna eat that chicken. 50 HP. Still gonna die instantly to a holy armor, but they're also not that hard to fight.
You found a heart thing, you said?
Yeah.
Was it a two-space heart room or a one-space heart room?
One space.
Hmm. You were not anywhere close to one, sadly.
Wow. It's fucked up.
If you can get to the far left, though, there's a very long, thin hallway going up and down on the far left. At the very top of it is a health increase.
Oh, fuck.
Did you die?
Yeah. I actually have to... I actually have to continue because I haven't save stated in a while. Yeah, I got no scoped from off screen.
Ugh.
Not really much I can do about that.
Nope.
Jesus, though, I was like, alright, the one's there, I don't have to worry about it, and then, like, the fucking other one just zapped me. I don't think I actually went back too far, and the only reason I really had that much damage was because I fucked up fighting the holy armor, so. This is ultimately fine. I'm gonna skip that one heart upgrade that requires the huge box pushing thing. I can do that in my own time. Which is just this room, so I just fall to the bottom of this room. And I think we're back where we were already.
Pretty much.
I just won't complete that part of the map, and that will remind me to go back down there. Oh, no, wait. I do this one too. I'll take a potion. So you're saying this area is actually pretty huge?
It's reasonably large, but if you can get to the hallway that goes, you really should call it a tower on the far left.
Fuck.
If you can scroll on over to it. At the very top's a health thing, and then it's not that far away from a save point from there. But this place is going to be kind of mean and not give you many access points to healing. Oh, interesting.
What?
Just, there's a lot of hidden stuff in this area.
Yeah, probably. I bet. Huh. I wonder if this is progress. Jesus. God, so many enemies in this game.
So, that save point that you have, the first save point in this area, the space directly below it is where the health upgrade is, so that's where you need to get around to.
Oh my god. Why? What? Why did I think I could damage race a thing?
Did you try to damage race a holy armor?
No, I tried to damage race a grizzly.
Eh.
They're man, so tanky. Race and a Dottien. Holy shit. The increase in difficulty of this stage is ridiculous. Alright, speedrun time.
I think at some point this game's like, so have you been grinding for a while? Because you should have been grinding for a while.
Yeah, speaking of grinding, I might have to do that off screen between this week and next week. I'll definitely just like go for every card I have available, and then by the end of that it should be at a decent level.
Yeah, go for every card. If you actually look at a map and want to look around, there are a lot of things you can pick up for those little health upgrades, which help.
So about that fast forwarding.
Did you get yourself killed again?
No. I just realized in that one really... That really one big room has like the big box pushing thing. You can just fast forward that.
See? It's helpful.
Alright. They're saying right below.
Yeah, right below where that save point is. The space directly underneath it is where the health thing is.
Apparently running into the holy armors doesn't do that much damage. It's specifically getting hit by the sword.
Yeah, the sword or the projectile.
Fucked up. Alright, I got a level. Take that. Alright, so first, we're gonna get this, I don't even remember what was over here. There's a heart up, alright. Get this heart up. And then I think I see where your life increase thing is. And then as soon as I get into that fucking column room with the succubi, I'm gonna do another state. Holy shit.
Oh, the long column room? Yeah. Enjoy the succubi, because I think they're everywhere.
But they drop a card, so I'm kind of okay with that.
These incredibly annoying enemies drop something I kind of sort of want.
Oh, the only reason they're annoying is because they fly around. They don't even do that much damage, I don't think. Oh. I see. I have discovered the puzzle. Oh, Griffin's back.
Griffin's gonna wreck your face.
It's seriously like... The second you leave a room, sometimes they replace it with a different enemy. As that was the puzzle room before, with just two fox archers. No, Griffin. There we go. Puzzle solved. So they need to do a running jump. So, fun fact about that room that you said, below the save point, that has the thing in it. I can't get to it from here.
Oh, it's a rock, feather thing?
No, you'll see in a moment with the map.
Well, in that case, just go all the way down.
Oh, balls.
Did you die?
No. We're gonna play with this. We'll make a new save state.
But that long column room that's right below the save point, just go all the way to the bottom. Just drop all the way down.
Alright. Nothing interesting in any of this shit.
There is, but you need to heal first, and then you can go back for the other stuff.
Fuck. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Fuck!
Did playing... you die again?
The plan has problems.
Okay.
Whoa, this room, what is happening here? I need to kill some of these bone towers. Also, I need to figure out this... Because I need to kill these so I can actually move at a decent speed and figure out this puzzle. Okay, never mind. I destroyed one box and the frame rate immediately gets better. I don't think that's the way that was meant to be solved, but that's the way I'm gonna solve it. Okay. This is fine because I lost a lot of health in that one column room.
Okay.
So I'm just not gonna speed run to the bottom because you kinda can't run past sucking by it. It kinda keep coming for you. Okay. I don't think you meant to not fight the succubi.
I just meant get down to the bottom. I didn't mean, like, literally throw yourself to the bottom.
I mean, you might need to be specific.
Sorry about that.
No, it's fine.
Remember, I'm only looking at a map. I don't see where the enemy placements are.
Yeah, I mean, what? I should really try and figure out why it's such a slowdown. I need to look it up. I might be using the wrong, like, video option or something.
Well, after this boss, it might not be a bad idea to take a break.
Lies.
Fair enough.
I'll be fine.
I trust you.
Alright, now that we have progressed, like, two fucking rooms. Apparently, poltergeists deal a ton of damage. Or enough to kill a very weak man. Found a secret. It's empty. But if I don't get it now, I'll think that I've gotten it. And I found a place to farm griffins at the very least. Forest armor? Why would you think that forest armor would be weak to a flame sword?
I've bet a good lot of money. Good bit of money.
Ah, save point.
There you go.
Alright.
If you found the save point, you were very close to the boss then.
Forest hammers drop a card.
I don't believe they actually do.
They drop something though.
Probably some, and this is going to sound silly, armor.
Yeah, was. I love how like half the enemies in this game are like, is it an armor? Is it a demon?
Pretty much.
Plays game of chicken with the forest armor. Whoops.
You are a goofball.
No, I didn't get hit. I accidentally threw a cross. And then intentionally threw a cross, but got, like, no damage off of it. Oh, right. The whip becomes big at the end. Like, these forest armors are protecting something. A tree. It's apparently what a dryad is. And golem. This is the boss golem. I wonder if golem drops a golem card.
Don't you already have the golem card?
I do. But I'm just, you know, I'm waxing poetic now.
He might. But I wouldn't worry about it. I'm pretty sure only there are very few enemies in this game that, or rather, very few cards in this game that are dropped by multiple enemies.
Okay, hold up. I need to take care of this thing first. I'm gonna beat this golem over the head with a stick. That probably was not worth it, but it was funny to me. In this room, it's gonna be a single stat up. Like, let's not even kid. Golem really doesn't do much other than walk at you threateningly.
That's all he has to do.
There's a slide thing, but I believe that. Yes, that. Holy crap! Hellbolt, no! Dumps you back out, like, way at the beginning of the game. It was an HP max, so this was entirely worth it.
There you go.
Alright, now let's go fight a boss. And then if I die, I'm not going to go through here again, because I'll probably have to come through here. Anyway, to leave quickly.
I'd recommend having... Nah, you know what? You'll find out.
I'll be fine. I'm good at this game. Oh. I see.
Yeah, it's him.
Hello, Death. That just seems like a harder version of the Necromancer.
But you have a lot more cards now, which can help out.
Whoa. I might want to get that look at Death.
He's
Why am
fine.
I not doing my slide? I'm like hitting down, but I'm not doing slide. Okay, that is targeted at you. It doesn't go straight down. All right. Yeah, it seems like with the, like, I guess if there's 5 bosses or 10 bosses after it keeps happening, I'm clearly hitting down and jump and it's just throwing me up in the air. At the last boss, which would mark the latter half of the game, they switch up the boss music.
I guess these guys are supposed to be the real deal, rather than the chumps you've been fighting before.
Exactly. What a terrible night that occurs. So I'm gonna throw something out here. Nah, figured that would happen. Does Death have, I don't know, 4,444 HP?
No.
Wow, weird.
He actually has much, much less than that.
That's generally how much they give him.
I know, but not this time. He actually has very little health, it's just that he's hard to hit.
Yeah, I might try a different sword. Or a sword? A fire sword might actually just be the best. As I stated before, my issue with Rose Sword is if you hit with those roses first, you're... Oh, also, it doesn't do any more damage than the Fire Sword, never mind. Yeah, it's, there we go. Is there a better sub-weapon for Death?
Well... no, the cross or cards, because the cross is amazing for him, if you can hit it.
That was a bad cross. Doing like a jump-canceling sort of thing.
Yeah.
It's working.
If you're having problems with any of the stuff that he does, shields are pretty good.
I'm not actually having any problem with that.
Okay.
For the most part. Like, I'll get hit every now and then, but not to a super extreme.
Yeah, I don't remember death being that much of a problem in this game. Obviously, he's not as ridiculous as he is in, like, say... Well, is he that bad in Symphony of the Night?
I don't think he's in Symphony.
Oh.
Loon, you're playing that recently.
Oh, yeah.
Is death in it?
I haven't seen if he's a boss in it yet, but he appears.
Oh, you're right. He's straight up in the game. Of course he'd be a boss.
Like, I think that's one of the only bosses you fight in every castle.
What?
What happened?
Wait, what?
Use your words.
What? Death, is this your form that is supposed to be frightening and, like, imposing? Is this what you're going with here?
Sure, let's go with that.
Fucking effed up turtle.
Also, yeah, they used the B-team's monster designs for this.
I mean, wrecked, I'm probably gonna die, yeah. Yeah. Found a use for it. Also, I'm starting to notice that the, I think the scythes might actually have a pattern. What is that him hitting the ground supposed to do? But yeah, Tonfers. Actually got that range on them.
Every time I hear the name, I'm like, what the hell are you... Oh, right, Tonfas.
Not Tonfas.
I necked them. I was actually doing really good there for a while. Alright, this just means don't use crosses on first form. I was like, is this one of the ones where death has two forms? I can't remember. And then I, you know. Oh, look, he's dead. Wait, why did I not get a level up? I probably should have gotten a level up. Oh, right. He probably has two forms. Alright, this time, though. Also, this is going to be a long video. My alarm went off during that last attempt at some point. He's way manageable. Oh, wait! Ah, I've come up with an ingenious strategy. The old bat tech strategy. Come on. Stop getting hit by my fucking backswing. What are you doing, Death? Are you just walking into my sword? Scythes. Scythe has problems. The scythes have problems.
Mm-hmm.
There's way more scythes during this first form. Oof, I ran right into that one.
God, yeah, this is what I was going to suggest, putting up a shield.
Alright, there we go, form two. Alright, this is just toss some crosses. This is going to be way easier. Since I actually have crosses to toss. Slow down.
Yeah, there's too many sides on the field. Think of it this way. The slowdown helps you dodge them.
Oh, okay, I see. If you're on the ground when he slams. Alright, I got one less hit. How much health do you have?
Whole bunch.
I'm out of crosses. And I like hit with every one. Alright, I have one heart. The heavy spell is kind of annoying too.
Yeah, I know.
I missed time to jump. Holy balls. Alright. I'm gonna stop the recording here, which could kill him next time.
Okay.